الطاهرين. We continue our discussion about the characteristics of Allah in the Quran, and this is sermon number 10 that we continue a reflection on this subject which is very important in the Quran. إن الآيات الأخيرة من سورة الحشر تشتمل ثمانية عشر من أسماء الله الحسنى. Last week we started talking about the last three verses at the end of سورة الحشر. That these three verses incorporate almost 20% of أسماء الحسنى in the Quran, because almost 18 beautiful names of Allah out of almost 100 Asma'ullah in the Quran. This shows that the reason the riwayat and tradition emphasize on importance of these three verses, like inna isma Allah al-a'zam fi hadhihi al-ayat. The hadith says that if you are looking for the ism al-a'zam, the greatest name of Allah, keep repeating and reciting these three verses, because one of those 18 names is Ism al-A'zam. And there is a hadith from Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, عَلَيْكَ بِآخِرِ الْحَشْرِ وَقِرَاءَتِهَا. That keep reciting the final verses at the Surah al-Hashr. مَنْ قَرَأَ آخِرَ الْحَشْرِ غُفِرَ لَهُ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِهِ وَمَا تَأَخَّرَ. If you recite these three verses, if you recite it with understanding, قَرَأَهَا حَقَّ قَرَأَتِهَا وَعَارِفًا بَحَقَّ هَذِهِ الْآيَاتِ. With understanding the meaning and the purpose of these verses, if you do it that way, then you are مَغْفُورٌ لَهُ, that you are forgiven by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All three verses start with هو الله. هو الله الذي لا إله إلا هو عالم الغيب والشهادة هو الرحمن الرحيم. We explained this verse last week. The second verse starts with the same sentence. هو الله الذي لا إله إلا هو الملك القدوس السلام المؤمن المهيمن. The first quality and the first characteristics in the second verse is that, first of all, he is Allah. Who is Allah? La ilaha illahu, the one God, the God of unity and oneness. But this time is al-Malik. You know that al-Malik comes from al-Mulk in Arabic, while al-Malik comes from milk. So we have Mulk means authority and kingdom. But then we have milk, which means amlak, property. So Allah is al-Malik. We can say Allah is al-Malik. Maliki yawm al-Din or Maliki yawm al-Din, both are correct. But this Allah is the absolute authority, al-Malik. Because you and I, we may have some Malikiyah and some Mulkiyah, but is just takhayyulat, is not real. We may work for 30 years, 40 years, 60 years, and then you say, oh, I am demonic, I'm owner of this property, owner of that land, owner of that car. But what kind of authority and ownership you and I have that with one heart attack we are finished? We have no authority over anything with one heart attack. We have one stroke, and there is nothing we can do. And even if this doesn't happen, even if we live for 80 years or 90 years and have everything, but the moment we die, we just take one kafan with us. There is nothing of our authority and nothing of our ownership or any of this property. We cannot take anything with ourselves. But when we say Allah, al-Malik, he is real. He is real owner. He is real kingdom and authority. As-salam, He is Allah of peace. Salam is one of the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, Allahumma anta salam wa laka salam wa milka salam wa ilayka yahud salam.
You are about peace. And if there is any peace anywhere, you are the source of it.
Wallahu yad'u ila dar as-salam. When he invites to peace.
يَهْدِي بِهِ اللَّهُ مَنِ اتَّبَعَ رِضْوَانَهُ سُبُلَ السَّلَامِ.
If you choose the path of pleasure of Allah, you are choosing the path of peace.
So his pleasure is in his peace, as-salam. When he wants to talk about Abraham,
Salamun ala Ibrahim, Salamun ala Musa wa Harun, Salamun ala Nuh, Salamun ala al-Mursaleen, Salamun ala Ali Yasin.
Always Allah talks about as-salam and peace.
And even on the day of judgment, when people communicate in heaven, tahiyyatuhum fiha salam. That's all. All the exchange is the words of peace.
In this dunya, Allah says, فَإِذَا دَخَلْتُمْ بُيُوتًا فَسَلِّمُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِكُمْ تَحِيَّةً
تَحِيَّةً مِنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ مُبَارَكَةً طَيِّبًا. When you enter someone's house, say salam.
When you say salam عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِكُمْ, because you are part of that audience. When you salam to someone, you are doing salam to yourself.
So in reality, you are saying salam to the owner of that house, to your host.
But in reality, you are saying salam to yourself.
And then another verse, إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَمَلَائِكَتَهُ يُسَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا صَلُّوا عَلَيْهِ وَسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا. So Allah is talking about salam, and in this world, in hereafter, in communication with the messenger, in communication with the ordinary people, always the exchange of salam. قال عليه السلام على المسلم أن يرفع صوته بالسلام. الصغير على الكبير، المر على القاعد، القليل على الكثير. So the first word is to say salam alaykum, peace be upon you. And we, brothers and sisters, have to follow the example of the Prophet. Anytime he sees anyone, he is the first one who says salam. People, they have a very hard time. They try to somehow surprise the Prophet by saying salam first. This time we hide ourselves behind the jidar or somewhere, that we say salam to the Prophet before he says. And still they fail to do so. Always he is the first one that somehow he's a smarter to start to say salam, even to the kids. The Messenger of Allah, he sees the children, and he is the one who says salam alaikum. Some people think it's arrogant. They think if you say salam, then you are putting yourself down. And you are the one who should be the subject of salam, or the object of salam. But when we look at the tradition, it's not like that. يَوْمَ لَا يَنْفَعُ مَالٌ وَلَا بَنُونَ إِلَّا مَنَتَ اللَّهِ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ.
Even at that day, we need to have a qalb of salam, a peaceful heart.
And this is one of the asma Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-Malik As-Salam.
Al-Mu'min.
Allah is the Mu'min. One of the meaning of iman is tasdeeq. Who al-Mu'min ay al-Musaddiq. Yani yusaddiqu fi'luhu qawla. When Allah says something, he practices what he preaches. He does. Wa man asdaqu min Allah qawla. As a Mu'min, we have to start with trust and honesty of God. If you believe that Allah is Astaghfir Sadiqeen, this is really the foundation of our faith. And then apply it to our life.
Al-Mu'min huwa al-Musaddiq. Ma'nahu al-Mu'min idha wa'ada wafa.
When we promise, we have to practice. We have to keep our words. This is one of the meaning of al-Mu'min. Allah keeps his word.
The second meaning of al-Mu'min comes from al-aman. Allah is mu'min means He provides aman, He provides security and protection in physical world. Can you imagine if even look at the universe? Every moment there is some big change in this universe. A star dies or big heavenly object moves here and there. If one of them, one piece of those heavenly stones touch the ground, one of them is enough to destroy the whole United States. One of them. And this happens all the time, all those stones falling down all the time. But when they hit the atmosphere of the earth, they get melted and they get dust, and we get a little dust here and there. And sometimes miraculously a little rock comes down just to remind us that be careful, that He is moving, He is the one who is protecting you from all these stones from the sky. This is in a physical aman, but also in the spiritual world He provides you with security. You know, sometimes there is a little earthquake here and there, and people, you know, scared that, you know, one area earthquake, and we do Salatul Ayat, and everyone is scared. Can you imagine when the total zilzal come? It is zulzalat al-ardh zilzala. When is the protection at that time? Where is the aman at that time? That the total earth is going through a big quick. يَوْمَ تَرَوْنَهَا تَذَهَلْ كُلُّ مُرْضِعَةٍ عَمَّ رْضَعَتْ وَتَذَعُ كُلُّ ذَاتَ حَمْلٍ حَمْلَهَا وَتَرَى النَّاسَ سُكَارَى وَمَا هُمْ بِسُكَارَى وَلَكِنْ عَذَابَ اللَّهِ شَدِيدٌ. At that time, every pregnant woman drops her baby. And you look at people and you think that they are drunken. And they are not drunken. But the fear of that total earthquake and the change in this universe and beginning of the day of judgment scares everyone. And at that time, we are by ourselves. وَوَجَدُوا مَا عَمِلُوا حَاضِرًا. The only thing that we have is our action. The heaven and hell are manifestation of our action. We are ourselves. It's not that Allah made the hell, means He is using gas and oil to make fire to burn us. No, that's not the real story of hell. The real story of hell is that bu anfusakum wa ahlikum naran wa quduha an-nas wal hijar. Our bodies start burning. That means this body itself turned to hell. وَقُودُهَا النَّاسِ. The oil, the fuel of that fire is the physical body of the people. This is what the Quran says. That the body start burning because of سَيِّئَات. Because of so much sins that we make in our life. Isn't it that some people smoke a lot, and every time they smoke a little dark thing in their lung, and just, you know, increase and increase and increase, that occupies the whole lung? This is the way that we make masiyah and sins. And we bring all this fire to our soul and in our body. This is why we need Allah to be al-mu'min, to give us protection. As-salam al-mu'min. He is the source of peace and He is the source of protection. نعمتان مجهولتان لا يعرف قدرهما إلا من فقدهما الصحة والأمان. Then it's interesting that الصحة الأمان, السلام الأمان, they come together. The peace and security. And the same thing that He is al-mu'min, He is as-salam. And then the other verse says, مَنْ جَاءَ بِالْحَسَنَ فَلَهُ خَيْرٌ مِّنْهَا وَهُمْ مِّنْ فَزَعٍ يَوْمَئِذٍ آمِنُونَ. Subhanallah. It says the day of faza, the day of total fear, on the day of judgment, when that big zilzal happens, and everybody is that faza, that huge fear, those people who ja'u bil hasana, those who did good things in this life, fahum wa hum min faza'in yawma idhin aminun. They have their al-aman. Allah is the mu'min. He provides them with aman, with protection, with security, because of their own action. Because they did a good right thing. They said, man ja'a bil hasana, فَلَهُ عَشْرَ أَمْثَالِهَا. You do one thing, and Allah provides you with 10 hasana. I had a discussion, I think you heard it once from me, that with all this mercy of Allah, if someone goes to hell, that is shame. That we do one thing and Allah provides us with 10 hasanat, and then we do one bad thing, and He doesn't double it, He doesn't, you know, punish us 10 times. It's just one punishment for one sin, but 10 rewards for one good deed. With all this generosity, it's shame that we go to hell. Allah gave us so many opportunities. He gave us intellect, He gave us revelation, He gave us the Anbiya, He gave us the Quran, He gave us Masajidullah. If we miss all this opportunity and still go to hell, then we deserve it. What else we want Allah to do for us? Somebody was asking me that, you talk about the dinner of a house of wisdom last week, how can we support that? And the answer is, tawasaw bilhaq, wa tawasaw bilsabr, wa tawasaw bilmarhama. Allah is telling us that when there is something good, you share it. It's not only that we go and we support the mosque, but you share this with other people. You know how many times we go on Facebook and say, that is my status, and now I want to do this, and I want to say that, and all of this unnecessary thing. Looks like, you know, the world cares to know if I'm going to take a shower. Why necessary that people know that that's my status, that I'm taking a shower now? Use this technology of Facebook and email and internet to share the good news. Put it on your status that next week there is a dinner to support Islamic House of Wisdom. And I want to support this House of Wisdom because it's a beautiful house, because it's active, because it has so many educational services, because it's an honest and sincere center, because it's outreaches to other communities, because it's care for our youth, cares for our children, care for our religion, cares for our community. You can share this with everybody else on your Facebook. You can say it. You can say that if we expect the masjid to support us, we have to support the masjid. It's not about only education, brothers. Some people come and they have even physical and like material expectations from the masjid. So how? And then they go and say, oh, we went to the masjid. Masjid didn't support us. Masjid didn't pay for our rent. Masjid didn't pay for our utility. So how can masjid support paying people's rent? If when I asked the office, I said, we have two Eid here, Tuesday and Wednesday. When you open all these boxes and you said dhabiha and this and that, how much donation we received in such a huge Eid? And it's shame that we have Eid al-Fitr and Eid al-Adha is come and goes and just like nothing. You see the other community, there is only one Christmas and they admire it. They already started 2-3 months before Christmas, they start talking and advertising it. And for another like 2 months, almost 6 months, they are talking about that one occasion. And then we have a great Eid, not Eid al-Fitr and Eid al-Adha. So okay, how much we got? I said, maybe $470 or $500 altogether for all these two occasions. And how much the mosque had to pay? More than $3,000. I'm not talking about the salary of the staff, I'm not talking about the utility, I'm not talking about big bills. I'm talking about the stuff related to it, the shopping here, fixing little here. There was a problem in the kitchen, fix it. But you put just petty stuff, it's more than $3,000. And then you see that there are boxes in the community here and there, all these little boxes. Help the orphan, help the orphan. And subhanAllah, now it has become a big business in the community. We used to have one or two of them. Now all these boxes all over, we don't know even who they are. Of course we have to support the orphans in Lebanon, in Palestine, in Iraq, in Syria, everywhere. They need it. And those Syrian sheikhs, they said that people are so hungry in areas that it's okay for them to eat kids, dogs, and cats and dogs, and the dead body, because it's halal for them. Well, if you are so courageous to issue a fatwa to say that it is halal to eat cats and dogs and dead body, why you don't show some courage to invite these people to have a dialogue and negotiation in this foolish war and bring peace to the people? Why you are so stubborn? It's okay to eat dog, but it's not okay to have a dialogue. These are brothers in Islam, brothers in language. That is shame. We have to help them. But then also the masajid needs support to educate, to promote this faith, to reach out to other communities. This is also our responsibility. We are busy working day and night, but there are some people, they don't have to work like we do, but they take these boxes here and there, they can go and get brandy. But we don't have even enough time to come up with the services. That last night when I got home, it was close to 11 o'clock. And my wife says that, did you eat? I said, no. How come? I'm sorry, we didn't make a dinner, because I thought we are in the masjid and it's Thursday night and you eat there, there is soup, there is food. I said, yes, there was a wedding. I went to Greenfield Manor, performed the marriage over there, and there was a huge dinner. But then I had to come back because I heard that there was a brother who came here and he wanted to convert, and there were some Ikhwan with him. Hadriyad was one of them who was with them. So we sat down here and almost hour and a half or so we were talking, and alhamdulillah that brother, he became Muslim, he converted to Islam, and we had a very happy time and conversation. So I didn't get a chance in the beginning, and then at the dinner I performed the marriage, came back right away. By the time I got home, it was almost 11 o'clock, and there was nothing to eat. She said, well, since you were not there, we didn't make it, you know, a dinner, but we made some soup for kids and ourselves, and maybe we still have some plate if you want me to warm that, because it's too late now to cook. So no problem. We go through this almost every day, brothers and sisters, because we believe in what we do. Aman al-Rasul bima unzila ilayhi min Rabbi. We have to have iman in what we do. But then you see some people, not only don't help us, but they hurt us. Yadlumunana, we are dhulamna fi, out of the khibatha of some individual, that you see, my goodness, how come some people can be so much khabith? That they do all this brainwash and abuse the ignorance of people, that, oh, you cannot even go to Dar al-Hikmah, you cannot even pray there, you cannot do this, you cannot do that. And they know what they say. And it says, subhanAllah, with the disease of ignorance in some people, sincerity in some people, and khibatha and evilness in some people, that they want to abuse. Even if you destroy Dar al-Hikmah, it's not going to help you. You think the only way for you to be successful as a center, as an individual, as a group, as an organization, in order for you to be successful, you have to destroy House of Wisdom. How you justify that? Where is Allah in this? Where is Akhlaq in this? Then some individuals, they go through, and I just got one message. That person might be in our audience, I don't mention the name. He said, Salaam alaikum, dear Imam, happy Eid. I need to apologize for the past. My problem is trusting people unwisely. Thank you for all you do and your patience. I have heard this from so many people. They said in different ways that people lied to us. They said things about you and about House of Wisdom that they were not right. So brothers and sisters, despite of all these services and sincerity, if you come here on Sunday, you may see like 600-700 Muslim and non-Muslim girls, that for the first time, that many Muslim and non-Muslim girls gather in any masjid in this state and probably in this country. And this is not the only time that we do the outreach and interfaith. We do a lot of activities like that. But then you go and share it. Put it on your Facebook. Put it, send an email. Call your friends. Communicate with them. And invite them to come to our dinner, inshallah, next Saturday at 4 o'clock. And remember the Prophet said, Ya Ali, an yahdillah bika rajulan wahidan khayrun laka min kull ma fi dunya. That is so rewarding. Let me end this by saying that when we talk about politics in community, you see, unfortunately, the same thing in the bigger world. You have some crazy guy like Netanyahu. Some people, they talk against Netanyahu, but they have the same mentality of Netanyahu, the same mentality. Now the whole world was amazed with this Dr. Zarif, the Iranian foreign minister, although he was moving with wheelchair, but with the type of PowerPoint presentation, he amazed the world. And even United States said that this negotiation was very clear, very useful. But then you have a crazy guy like Netanyahu and says, we still have to attack Iran. We have to do, still we have to do that. And it's up to America. Now choose. You want to choose somebody like Netanyahu, a crazy guy? Or you want to, if you want to choose as a friend, whom you choose? Somebody like Dr. Rouhani, a man of wisdom, man of honor, man of respect. You choose that one. Or a kadhab, a liar like Netanyahu. Which one? You choose the Iranian nation, thousands of years of civilization, and with all the tharawat and oil and gas and education and everything, or you choose a crazy guy like this man, you have to be careful. Okay, Iran made its case clear about nuclear power. Now it's time for you, Netanyahu, and those who support you, Kadhaf, to come and explain the same way what you have. If you really care about that, let us have the whole Middle East free of nuclear power. And then you have Saudi that they rejected the membership in Security Council, saying that, well, this is double standard. Yes, Security Council suffers from double standard, but let somebody else says this, not Saudis. You are not in position to talk about double standard. You are the biggest munafiq in the world. And you are the worst double standard in the world. And you are the part of problem in any problem in the world. And you are the real supporter of terrorism in the Middle East, whether it's in Iraq or Syria or Lebanon. Everything is halal for you, alcohol and all these bars and womanizing. Everything is halal for you. But for your people, they cannot even, the woman cannot drive. That is even haram for them. You are the real double standard. Out of 19 of terrorists, 17 of them came from you. And now you care about democracy in Syria, you care about democracy somewhere else, what you did in Syria, what you did in Bahrain. Now you are talking about double standard. No, dhahara al-fasad fil bahr wa bahr. This is the fasad coming out of those hypocrites and those munafiq themselves, because they talk about Allah, but it's just lip service. They forgot that the Prophet said, تَخَلَّهُ بَأَخْلَاقِ اللَّهِ. They are not people of Al-Malik, Al-Salam, Al-Mu'min, Al-Muhaymin. This is what we need. This tragedy of morality in the world, brothers and sisters. This moral tragedy has a solution. And the solution is to return to Allah. Alladhi la ilaha illa hu. Al-Malik, Al-Quddus, As-Salam, Al-Mu'min. If we provide these qualities, these beautiful names and characteristics of Allah in our life, if we bring something from Ar-Rahma, Ar-Rahmaniyya, then we find a solution for this world. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah al-Aliyyil Azim. Allahumma aslih ma fasada min umur al-Muslimin. Allahumma ghayyir su'a halina bi husni halik. Allahumma la tusallit alayna man la yakhafuka wa la yarhamuna. Allahumma shafi mardana wa ahdi hawajana wa fukk asrana wa taghammad arwah amwatina بالرحمة والمغفرة والرضوان. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات فتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر. صدق الله العلي العظيم. وإلى الصلاة.